because the church goes beyond the preacher. The church goes beyond the choir. The church goes beyond the position. The church is all about Jesus Christ.
At this time, we're going to hear another selection, my brothers and sisters, and then following that, we'll have the message for the hour. Amen.
Cold.
Would you bow your heads for a word of prayer? God, we thank you for all that we've experienced thus far. God, we thank you for the opportunity that we have had to give you praise. Will you remind us that we were created to give you praise? That it doesn't have to be a selected day or a moment in that day, but whenever we think of your goodness, we can give you praise. And so God, we give you praise right now for the previous days. God, we give you praise right now for this present day. And God, we even give you praise for the future, because the song reminds us that better days are even coming. This is a good day right now, but you've promised us better days. I pray right now for every household that's watching this. I pray for every need that is before you. I pray for those who are looking for strength and courage, those who just need a word from you. God, whatever it is, I pray that through this word, you provide and meet their need. Thank you for this Super Sunday. Thank you that we can just celebrate and worship you without form or script. Thank you, dear God, that we, your people, are able to celebrate you, our God, for being the master, creator, ruler of this world, universe, and our lives. Have your way now in and through this preached word. We pray, dear God, that whatever comes from it, you receive the glory. I pray for those who are already on this football field of life, trying to make it to the goal line. Continue to give them strength. I pray for those, dear God, who are in the stands right now because they haven't accepted you. But because of this message, because of this word, they're going to leave their old team behind and come up and hook up with this new team. Not Messiah's team, not Owens' team, but the team of Jesus Christ. We thank you, Lord. We praise you for this time. Have your way, God. In Jesus' name we ask it. And all of God's people said, amen. Amen. Come on, my brothers and sisters, let's give God another hand of praise. Come on. Come on. Listen, Super Bowl Sunday, I'm trying to do this a little different today. As you can tell, no suit. We all got everybody else got their team jerseys on. I refuse to wear my team jersey. That's a whole nother story. It's some personal matters. I'm working out with Jerry Jones. We're going to work that out. Hopefully next September, I'll be able to wear it again. But we are here. You are here to celebrate, to give God a super praise. And so, my brothers and sisters, there's a word I want to call your attention to. It's found in the Gospel of John, John chapter 21, verses 1 through 7. It's from the New Living Translation. When you get a chance, this entire chapter is so powerful, so profound. But I want to focus our attention this morning on verses 1 through 7. It reads this way. Later, Jesus appeared again to the disciples beside the Sea of Galilee. This is how it happened. Several of the disciples were there, Simon Peter, Thomas, nicknamed the twin, Nathanael from Cana in Galilee, the sons of Zebedee, and two other disciples. Simon Peter said, I'm going fishing. We'll come too, they all said. So they went out into the boat, but they caught nothing all night. At dawn, Jesus was standing on the beach, but the disciples couldn't see who he was. He called out, fellows, have you caught any fish? No, they replied. And then he said, throw out your net on the right-hand side of the boat, and you'll get some. And so they did, and they couldn't haul in the net because there were so many fish in it. And then the disciple Jesus loved said to Peter, it's the Lord. And when Simon Peter heard that it was the Lord, he put on his tunic, for he had stripped for work, jumped into the water, and headed to shore. I want to focus in on verse 6. Because then he said, throw out your net on the right side of the boat, the right-hand side of the boat, and you'll get some. And so they did. And they couldn't haul in the net because there were so many fish in it. This morning, my brothers and sisters, I want to preach to you from this subject, run it back. Run it back. Yes. So now listen. The title of this message actually came to me 2 weeks ago. I knew that Super Bowl Sunday or Super Praise Sunday was approaching. And 2 weeks ago, the Kansas City Chiefs were playing the Buffalo Bills to see who would make it to the Super Bowl, to this game. And of course, Kansas City won. And the star player of Kansas City, Patrick Mahomes, who is probably one of the great quarterbacks. I mean, he's just phenomenal. And you'll see him tonight. But in his press conference after the game, Mahomes sounded so assured that Kansas City would be in the Super Bowl. As a matter of fact, he said, when the season started, our goal, here were his words, he said, our goal was to run it back. That blew my mind. I said, wait a minute. He said, yeah, our goal was to run it back. That regardless of what happened last season, this season, we want to run it back. Now, you got to understand, I got excited when I heard it because growing up on the playgrounds in Dayton, Ohio, Resurrection Park, or playing on the basketball courts at the YMCA downtown Dayton, there were times in which we would use those words. See, when we were playing basketball, 5-on-5, there were times in which we would lose, but we would be so close to winning that once the team scored that winning bucket, we were frustrated. We were angry, and we would automatically say, run it back. Now, there were people waiting to get in the game. They had next, but we was like, no, we ain't leaving. Because we know that we can do this right. We know that we can win this game, so run it back. Patrick Mahomes said, when the season started, with COVID and everything, he said, our goal was to run it back. Now, whether or not they win the championship tonight, that's up to the Chiefs and the Buccaneers. But I wanted that to be the foundation this morning for this message, run it back. How many of you all have ever desired a do-over? How many of you have ever made some mistakes in your life and you wish you had another opportunity to get it right? I know I have. I listen, countless times that I've made mistakes, oftentimes, more times than not, because of my own doing or neglect, that I wish I had just another chance to get it right. Some of you have some broken relationships, some failed marriages, and you wish you had another opportunity. Listen, some of y'all waiting because next Sunday is Valentine's Day, and you planning already to get your love back. You just want one more chance. That's what Biggie said. Just give me one more chance. There are some of you who have lost jobs because of your own neglect. You showed up late. You didn't stay before it was time to clock out. You left early. It was your own demise. And you were saying to yourself, I wish I just had another opportunity to show what I could do on that job. There are some of you who have received a failing health report card. You had an appointment with your doctor and you got all F's. You ain't eating right. You ain't exercising. You're not taking your medication like you should. And a doctor has told you F. How many of us who have accepted Jesus Christ and promised to the Lord in countless prayers and conversations, and Lord, I'm going to do it right this time. I'm going to do your will this time. I won't mess up the next time, only to have another opportunity and you mess up again. My brothers and sisters, I want to give you a word of encouragement this morning that Jesus is standing right in front of you, whether it's in front of your bed, whether it's in front of that kitchen table or in front of that sofa. And Jesus is saying, in the words of Patrick Mahomes, let's run it back. That's what I love about Jesus. He gives us an opportunity to run it back. And it is all in the text this morning. It's all in the Gospel of John, chapter 21. Few things I want to drop on you, and I'm done. I'm getting ready for the game later. So let's get this praise on right now and get up out of here. The first thing, as Jesus is declaring to his disciples, he's declaring to us, Let's run it back, because this scene is so familiar. Jesus, as John records, Jesus has been crucified. He's been resurrected now. He is alive. He's come out of the grave. It was Mary Magdalene who he saw and told Mary, you go tell the disciples and I'm going to meet them. Tell them that I'm alive. She goes to them. They're not really sure whether or not he's alive. He shows up. He shows up and shows them who he is. He lets them know, I am here, but they can't really believe that it's him. So Jesus says, run it back. Because the scripture says 8 days later, because Thomas was not in the crowd the first time, 8 days later, he shows up again. And Thomas says, I can't believe it. Jesus says, put your hands here. Put your hands on my side. It's me. And now as we look at this 21st chapter, the scripture says, again, Jesus shows up. Why does Jesus keep showing up to his disciples? Because he wanted to teach them a lesson and he wants to teach you a lesson. Jesus is saying, run it back. Run it back, because you're going to find yourself in some precarious situations where you're going to feel all alone and isolated. You're going to be in situations that's all solitude. There's no one around you that can help you out, but Jesus says, run it back. Jesus wants you to run back the times when you felt all alone before, and Jesus wants to remind you that if I showed up back then in your situation, if I was with you back then, I am with you right now. Is there anybody here that can begin to praise God right now? Because you know your help ain't on the way. Your help is here right now. Jesus is declaring, I'm here. Run it back. And in case you find yourself in a situation and you feel like this is it, and you feel like this is different than anything you've ever experienced, and it's SOS and it's 911 all mixed up together, Jesus says, run it back. Run it back and look at what I've done in the past. This is where your super praise begins to come. Because when you begin to look at the number of emergencies you've had in your past, the number of setbacks, the number of distress signals you sent up to heaven, and God rescued you back then, you ought to be able to praise God even in your situation right now and declare, run it back. Yeah. Jesus shows up. The scripture says he shows up again. Yeah, Jesus is always there. Whoever you are, whatever it is you're going through, you've got company. He ain't coming. He's already there. John goes on to say that the disciples, here it is, the disciples were at the Sea of Galilee, and Peter decides that he wants to go fishing. And the other disciples, the seven who are there, it's seven total, they all get in the boat and they go fishing. And the scripture says that they fished all night and caught nothing. At dawn, they hear a voice from the shore holler out, hey, brothers, y'all catch any fish? Nah, we ain't caught nothing. And the man on the shore says, throw your nets out on the right side of the boat. And the scripture says that when they did, there were more fish than net. Have you ever had that kind of blessing where you got more fish than net? Where God has not only supplied your need, but God has met desires? Listen, I see Jesus. I love this scripture because I see Jesus saying, run it back. Run it back. What are you talking about? See, you got to understand that in the Gospel of Luke chapter 5, the scripture says that Jesus made his way to the Sea of Galilee. There were so many people who were trying to get close to Jesus and hear his teachings that they pressed upon him. They pushed their way to him. Jesus gets on a boat that is owned by a man named Simon, who we now know as Peter. And he tells Peter, listen, just push out a little way from the shore and let me teach this Bible study lesson. And Jesus teaches the lesson. And then Jesus says to Peter, now push on out a little deeper. And Peter says, here it is. Peter says, sir, you don't understand. We were fishing all night long, and we didn't catch a thing. And Jesus tells Peter in Luke chapter 5, throw your nets out this time because I'm on the boat. And once he does, there are more fish than net. That's Luke chapter 5. John chapter 21, the disciples have fished all night long, and they haven't caught a thing. And Jesus says, run it back. Drop it again. Now, I want to pause for a minute on this word because there's so much with this second run back. The first run back is Jesus is always there. Jesus will be there. Jesus is there. But this second point, there's so much because first, I am reminded of the miracle that takes place. That if Jesus could provide a miracle in Luke chapter 5, he wants his disciples to know, he wants you to know that he has the power to run it back. Yeah, I love Christ because he's not just a one blessing savior. He's not just a one miracle savior. He can do miracle after miracle after miracle. Somebody watching this right now is a living testimony that he has performed more than one miracle in my life. That he has told me time and time again to run it back. Is there anybody here that can begin to give some super praise right now because you are the beneficiary of more than one miracle? Then you ought to give God some praise and declare in your house, run it back. Yeah, because if he did it back then, he can do it right now. And if he can do it right now, I can even shout in my future because Jocelyn reminded me that better days are coming. Yeah, run it back. Jesus says, whenever you find yourself lacking, run it back. Whenever you feel as though no one can help you out, run it back. When you feel as though doctors can't do it and lawyers can't do it and the mortgage company can't do it, Jesus says, run it back. Hashtag run it back. Not only does his word blow my mind because Jesus shows me that miracles can happen again, but Jesus also shows me that I will get another opportunity. See, every time that we do something, it won't always bring about a positive result. This is what happens. The disciples are now operating in this exercise of futility. Luke chapter 5, Peter or Simon tells him, we've already been out all night and we haven't caught a thing. Jesus says, drop your nets again. Jesus wants him to know in Luke chapter 5 that you may have to do this thing more than one time. And sometimes, my brothers and sisters, you've got to try this thing over and over and over again. Is there anybody feeling me right now? Is there anybody that can declare that I didn't get it at the first time? I had to take that test two or three times, but by the grace of God, I passed it. I didn't get that home the first time. I got denied time after time, but I kept on submitting my application. And by the grace of God, I got it. I mean, go through your track list. Go through your history and begin to declare to Jesus, run it back. If he did it before, he can do it again. You got to keep pressing your way. Don't throw in the towel. Luke chapter 5, John chapter 21. Jesus is saying, run it back. But we were out here all night, dropping the nets, Jesus. And the man on the shore says, run it back. And Jesus is saying to somebody right now, as you are having this dialogue, this conversation with Christ, well, you don't understand. I done tried it for the 100th time. Jesus says, 101 will do. Just try me. And the scripture says that when they dropped the nets on the right side of the boat, the scripture says, when they followed the words of the man on the shore and they ran it back, more fish than net. Here it is. Run it back, run it back, run it back. Christ is always with you. Christ is always there. Christ will keep showing up. That's the good news in verse 1. He will continue to show up. 2, run it back. Miracles can happen again. But also you got to know that you might have to try this thing more than one time. Don't give up. Don't give up. Regardless of how frustrated you may feel, don't give up. Run it back. And then lastly, Jesus is reminding them of their calling. Run it back. So we're studying in our Bible study, if you want to walk on water, you got to get out the boat. And this past week, we talked about the call that God places upon our lives. And in many instances, God calls us to do things that we are unsure of and afraid to do. Yeah, God calls us to do the extraordinary. And God calls us to do it because God wants us to know that God, by way of the Holy Spirit, will empower us to accomplish whatever that call is. The results aren't yours, it's God. And so, my brothers and sisters, if you have a relationship with God, there's going to be a calling that God places upon your life. Listen, those of us who are recording this right now, there's a calling that God has given us gifts, and God has said to us, I want you to use these gifts that I've given you for my kingdom. I want you just to consider real quick, we almost done. Listen, the gift I have of speaking, I could be speaking about any and everything except Jesus Christ and possibly getting paid a whole lot more money. But he called me to do this. Listen, Regina and Alnisa and Jocelyn, that they could be singing elsewhere, different kinds of songs, but they're singing unto the Lord because that's their calling. Listen, Donovan on the keys, Joel on the bass, Melvin on the lead, Boo Man, Superb Herb on the drums, the ones and twos. Listen, they could easily be somewhere giving their gifts to the world, but they've made a commitment to give whatever they have. The calling is, I'm going to give my gifts to the Lord. You're watching this video because two people have been led by God to literally figure out how to work cameras and angles. You got a young brother up here who knows sound, that they are giving what they have. It's a calling. And I want somebody to know that whoever you are, God has given you a gift. And it's a calling that God says, just use it for my kingdom so that others might be blessed. Here it is. I'm going to blow your mind and I'm done. Because in Luke chapter 5, after Peter discovers this miracle, he realizes that Christ is different than everybody else. And the scripture says in Luke chapter 5, because of what Peter experienced with Christ on that boat, he left everything behind and he followed him. Peter followed Christ after that miracle. And in John chapter 21, Peter has denied Christ three times. He is now alone and feeling isolated. Now let's go back to the question. Because in Luke chapter 5, Jesus tells Peter and the other fishermen who will become disciples, I'm going to show you how to be fishers of men. I love it. I love it. I could do it all day, but I can't. Kickoff is coming soon. But Jesus tells them in Luke 5, I'm going to show you how to be fishers of men. Come on now. John chapter 21, Jesus asked them the question, have you caught any fish yet? You missed it. And they tell Jesus, we've been out here all night, we haven't caught anything. Listen. The fish in the net deals with their financial security. But the real question has to do with their calling. Because if Jesus tells them, I'm going to show you how to be fishers of men, Jesus is putting that calling upon their life. And thanks be to God that Jesus gives Peter, Jesus gives you, Jesus gives me another opportunity to accept that calling and do what God has called me to do. Listen, I talked about opportunities. I started out talking about, have you ever had missed opportunities? Well, here's a chance for you to get your super praise on. Because the God that I serve, even if I've had a missed opportunity, he comes back and gives me another opportunity to accept his calling. He gives me another opportunity to get it right. He gives me another opportunity to cast that net. My brothers and sisters, I'm just here to encourage you. Jesus is saying, run it back. If you've walked away from Christ because of your frustrations, because of your failures, because of your fears, Jesus is saying, run it back. Come on, let's run it back. Do this thing with me and I'll show you how to be fishers of men. To God be the glory. For another opportunity to get it right, to God be the glory for our Savior Jesus Christ. For declaring in our spirit this morning, run it back. My brothers and sisters, I want to encourage you this month to run it back. Don't just try it one time and settle for failure, but run it back. Run back the blessings. Run back the praises. Run back the miracles, everything that Jesus has done. And whenever you think of God's goodness this month, I want you to give God a super praise. Because we serve an awesome God. God bless you, my brothers and sisters. Run it back in Jesus' name. Amen.